We're going on the clock now. We'll put these guys on 1 minute as a group to weigh in on several topics. So first up, APS elections were held this week. The Bernalillo County Clerk reported the turnout was, wait for it, 2.6%. Lower than in some past elections, but not by much. Janice, I know, it's interesting. Local elections are always tricky, but especially for school boards. I've never understood this. The most impactful body, perhaps, on so many families in this city, and so many people just don't even pay attention to it. What's your sense of the election this go around?
Well, I think that happened again. Mm-hmm. And so here are the systemic problems. Mm-hmm. One is we have a constitution that says that we will have separate elections for school boards. Right. By the way, school boards actually manage more than 50% of the state's budget. So you are right that it's absolutely critical that you pay attention here. Yeah. But the elections come at such an odd time. And even when I was serving, every year we tried to get that constitutional amendment changed so that school board elections could be held with another election. They're very expensive.
Yeah.
And do you want to know why it kept failing?
Uh-uh.
It was really kind of sad. But the union membership would come in and say, we don't want this.
Interesting.
We don't want this. Mm-hmm. And now I think it is doing a disservice not only to the state, but to that very membership itself.
Interesting. Jeff, we had no small amount of controversy for one of the board members who lost, Kathy Court. Does that help or hurt an election? We have a controversy on the school board? The type of controversy was interesting.
It didn't seem like it particularly impacted voter turnout, and I will say this, that the percentage of calls that come into the news station from viewers who are upset about things, and the percentage of that relates to APS is not reflective of 2.6% of people turning out to the polls.
Seriously?
We get a lot of calls about different kinds of concerns about schools, and of course we do. It involves the state's children.
Yeah.
So for 2.6% of people to have showed up and voted, I think that's embarrassing.
Yeah.
And I don't know what a controversy really does in terms of impacting turnout. I gather the turnout in Kathy Court's race was a little higher than in some of the others.
Right.
I think 2.6 is such a minuscule percentage.
Bad.
It's unacceptable.
It's interesting, isn't it, Tom, your thought?
Yeah, it's not cost effective, that's for sure. You know, I mean, when 2.6%, it's very low voter turnout. But I think we need to reestablish our expectation of what we expect from the school boards. And, you know, as far as what type of impact they really have. They can control three things, budget, policy, and hiring a superintendent.
Right.
And that's it. And I think you could look at the numbers from two perspectives. From one perspective, you can look at the low voter turnout, that people are happy and they see that there's no need for them to get involved, or that they're really disenfranchised and they have no desire to get involved with that mess.
Sure.
Unfortunately, I think it's more the latter than the previous.
I think you might be right. Your thought, John?
Well, it's an interesting election because of what it represents. I mean, here you have a partial takeover of the APS board by Governor Martinez, which didn't, I mean, I think the insiders kind of were reading that in the newspaper and seeing it on the news, but I think the broad electorate don't understand. There were a lot of core issues, like Court was talking about two key issues that are highly contentious in our society right now. The teacher evaluation system at the state level, which is one of Governor Martinez's main proposals through Secretary-designate Scandera. And then also this Common Core agenda nationally, which is very controversial. And so she got taken out, being the most vocal opponent of both of those things. Interestingly, that may be kind of personality-based. Then there was also her husband being fired, who had worked for the governor,
the
former AP reporter, Tim Court. And so what you have is you have very interesting politics going on in these races, but it didn't seem to break through to the electorate
at all. We'll take a little more time, way over a minute here, but just let me ask you a question here. I mean, Ms. Court had a lot of things thrown at her, a lot of mailers, a lot of money went against her here. Is it a fair fight? I mean, was that a...
Probably, some of this she brought on herself. I mean, I actually might have supported some of her stand on some of those issues, but she, in my opinion, having been in 9 different school systems across the country, the rudest school board member I have ever met, disrespectful. So she kind of brought some of this on herself, even though her positions may have been right in some cases.
Interesting.